The Nepal government has planned to conduct a census in the Indian areas including Lepu Lake, Limipi Adura and Kalapani of Pitoragarh, which they have claimed as theirs. These are the same areas that Nepal had shown in their map and has printed in their textbook and coins. Study revealed that just about 44% of Indians are wearing the mask amid the pandemic. The study taken by Ek Desh was conducted across 18 cities in the country. While 50% of the people stated breathing issues as a reason to avoid masks, about 44% faced discomfort. Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on September 23rd announced the retirement of 11 Rajya Sabha members in the month of November. The retiring members have contributed significantly to the House and they have also dedicated the cause of democracy, stated Naidu. The ED attaches the proceedings of a money laundering case worth Rs 2000 crore. Under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002, the money has been attached to movable properties that belong to Surya Vinayaka Industries Limited and its group companies. According to the investigation, under PMLA, the accused had fraudulently availed for a loan worth Rs 2240 crores from various banks. Consecutive explosions have been reported at the ONGC plant in Gujarat at around 3 a.m. on September 24th. A massive fire broke out after the three consecutive blasts took place at ONGC Hazira plant in Surat. Surat collector Dhaval Patel said the firefighters at the spot are taming the fire and no casualties have been reported. Central Board of Secondary Education informed the Supreme Court on September 24th that the results of the compartmental exams for Class 12 will be announced on October 10th. The University Grants Commission also stated that the admission process will close on October 31st. Earlier, students had filed a petition as they were unable to take their admissions as the improvement exams were not conducted by CBSE yet. With an aim of modernizing the railways with cutting-edge technology, the Indian Railways has extended its MOU with IIT Kanpur. According to the MOU, IIT Kanpur will work on improving the railways by well-planned utilization of scientific assets through Center for Railways Research. The research will focus on the train and the track safety using signal processing, electric safety, traction installation and other related issues. Nobel laureates this year will get extra 1 million crowns with the prize money being revised to 10 million crowns as well. The Nobel Foundation said this was done due to the stable condition of its coast and capital. Henny Kisten, who heads the Nobel Foundation, says this will continue to rise from time to time, although the prize money has seen very few changes in the year 1980 and 2017. This AMG 53 Coupe has been launched at the price of Rs 1.20 crore in India. The car is second GLE Coupe model and is a replacement of GLE 43 Coupe. It has been powered by 3.0-litre twin-turbo inline-6 petrol engine which produces 435 bhp. Atletico Madrid has signed Luis Suarez from Barcelona after the Catalan team's coach Ronald Koeman indicated on an end to Suarez's 6-year deal. Atletico will pay 6 million euros to FC Barcelona to sign the 33-year-old footballer. Barca on this deal said the club would likely to publicly express its gratitude to the player for his commitment and wishes him all the success in future.
Thank you for listening to Briefly News. Have a wonderful evening.